Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time for those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy.
How's it feel, Jim?
Good, feel good. Boy, he's over there, he's going down. He's going. Hang on right now.
Well, folks, it's time to wet a line because it's Fishin' Affliction time. And thank you for joining us for today's episode of Fishin' Affliction TV. And this, folks, is a certified fan favorite. Stars and Stripers Part 2 with Captain Joe James, the ultimate sportsman, Mr. Jim Summers, the big dog, and myself chasing big old hybrid and rockfish out there on Percy Priest. We'll have a product spotlight on Real Magic. Don't forget to visit the online store there at fishinaffliction.com for a bunch of those Fishin' Affliction goodies. You can watch all your favorite episodes of Fishin' Affliction TV there at our YouTube channel. And our Fishin' Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week is at the end of the show. So sit back and enjoy this certified fan favorite, Stars and Stripers Part 2, with Captain Joe James, the ultimate sportsman Jim Summers, the big dog, and myself chasing big old hybrid and rockfish on Percy Priest, right here on Fishin' Affliction TV. Well, folks, last week's episode ended with the big dog catching this big old Percy Priest hybrid and everybody in the boat poking a little fun at the big dog's catch.
Joe, is that an average size or bigger size?
I'd say that's about average right there. Maybe a little above average. Just well, that's seven and a half.
That's a dandy fish.
Y'all are sure talking about my fish a lot.
Well,
I mean, you know.
That fish was putting a whooping on you to begin with, wasn't he, big dog?
That fish went to the bottom twice.
Sure did, didn't
he? Oh, man.
He went to the bottom.
Give me, hold him up one time for me. Boy, what a dandy fish. A little over average, you say?
Yeah. Well, yeah, he's right on that average line.
That's a beautiful fish. Beautiful
here,
fish.
Here, let me see. This is what I do with my fish. I don't know what y'all do with yours here.
Yeah, you got the what we call the long arm big extension.
Yeah.
You need real long arms.
There you go.
Long arms are bigger than fish, right?
There you go.
Now, we just got into these fish again. Tell me why.
Well, the fish, I think I moved. You see the mark right there? We have moved about 100 yards from where we were. So the fish that were active may have moved on up here a little ways, and we just lucked up and got on top of them again. So,
and a good size fish.
Yeah, the only reason I threw out that marker basically was to where I could have something to relate to in this open water.
Sure.
Because it's hard to keep track of where you're
absolutely
at.
Absolutely. All right. Here, we're back at it. And how's Mr. Belly doing, other than just growing by the second?
Let me tell you what. Mom made these especially for me, I can tell.
She does. She does, actually. She knows that for you to keep that girlish figure that you're working on. If you'd put the rest of those in either in your belly or in the thing.
Well, folks, after the big dog ate all the crackers out of Mama's big old lunch bag, it was time for me to lean on over and set that hook with some authority. And that's exactly what I did.
It's got any weight. There you go.
Get off. Nope. Coming at the boat.
Maybe that's a bass, Dan. Maybe that's a bass on that one. Well, he's got a lot of power now, doesn't he?
A little bit more, anyway.
Where are you going, Dan? We need to move some rods or what?
No, he's going
to
need
to move
here.
This one here might be.
I got to you.
Yeah.
summer showed me how to do that.
Hey, that's a better fish than you think it is. I didn't see him. That's a better fish than you think. He's going to be green on you. He's going to go for the bottom. And Dan Firmney, expert hybrid fisherman.
Years and years of fishing with Joe James.
That is a good one.
Look how much energy that man has.
That's a striper, isn't it?
Good hook set. That's a hook set.
Yeah. That's a good one.
I'm about to let this thing roll a little bit.
Hold him up, Dan.
That's a pretty one. Now Joe's got him. He's going, this is the man that put us on it, because he knows exactly where they're at.
Good job, man. That's that's great. Four, and we hadn't been here very long. And we've had five or six bites.
There we go. Now, Joe, can I fish the original rod that we were working on?
Sure. No problem.
Well, folks, the guys with the funny-looking hats have just landed another beautiful Percy Priest hybrid. And in a moment, folks, we're going to be right back with the certified fan favorite, Stars and Stripers, out there with Captain Joe James, the ultimate sportsman, Mr. Jim Summers, the Big Dog, and myself in the wilds of Percy Priest. And speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, meet Mr. Bernie Short, and he is holding an absolute monster smallmouth that he caught on legendary Dale Hollow on a recent trip. And this is the famous father-son fishing team of Daddy Mickey Short with a dandy catfish and his son Devin Short with a good-looking largemouth and a big old smile. And another famous father-son fishing team, well, this is Dad John Roberts with a 5-plus-pound largemouth, and this is his son Kyle with a big old largemouth that he caught out of the farm pond. Thanks for all the pictures, guys. Folks, you can send us your pictures at pics@fishandaffliction.com, and be sure to visit the picture galleries at our Facebook page and also our website. And be sure to send us your pictures, and maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild, your pictures in the wild.
When I developed the sexy shad color, I was looking for what a shad looks realistically in the water. I wanted the same color in the back, in the sides, in the belly, that yellow line. I wanted that glow. When that bait moves through the water, I wanted it to look like the real thing. And that's what the sexy shad does. The sexy shad looks so realistic that I know a bass can't pass it up. There's only one original sexy shad, and that's the one that I designed for Strike King. Did I tell you? It's sexy.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Drowning doesn't look like what you would think. Unlike what you would see on television or in the movies, most drowning victims don't usually splash violently or yell for help. Each year, over 700 children drown, with nearly one half drowning within 25 yards of a parent or supervising adult.
Place a properly fitting life jacket on your child when you are on or near water. Remember, drowning can occur in just seconds. So learn the look of drowning, because the life you save could be your child's.
The Turn Trail, for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Readymix. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Folks, here's the tournament trail results from Mike's Thursday night tournament there on Percy Priest Lake on June 28th, 2012. In first place with 19.80 pounds, a team of Nolan Poteet and Justin Earps, who also had the big largemouth that weighed 7.31 pounds. And in second place with 12.90 pounds, a team of Tony Farrell and Wayne Godfrey. In third place with 12.53 pounds, a team of Barry Steele and Robert Brownlee. And in fourth place with 8.91 pounds, a team of Jack Nichols and Roy Byrne. Congratulations to all those who participated, and thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for sponsoring the tournament trail. And now back to Fishin' Affliction. Well, folks, welcome back to this certified fan favorite, Stars and Stripers, part two there on Percy Priest with the big dog, the ultimate sportsman, Mr. Jim Summers, and Captain Joe James, who's got a smack in the middle of a bunch of hybrid and rockfish.
Joe, we're in them pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
Well, folks, while Captain Joe James is preparing us for some fish in action that's about to happen, let me tell you about the fish that we're after. Now, the top fish in this picture is a hybrid, also called a Cherokee bass, and this fish is a cross between a white bass and a striped bass. And you can see that its lines are broken that run down the side of the fish. Now, these fish are commonly caught in that 5 to 6 pound range, but the state record in Tennessee is a 23-pound, 3-ounce fish caught in the Stones River in 1998. Now, the bottom fish there, well, that is the big daddy. That is a striped bass, also called a rockfish and a striper. And as you can see, its stripes or lines are not broken at all. Now, these fish get into that 15 to 30 pound range commonly, but the biggest one caught in Tennessee is a 65 pound, 6-ounce giant caught there in the Cordell Hole Reservoir area. And that was in 2000. And these are the same waters that Captain Joe James and his guide service will put you in if you're after trophy stripers or some hybrid and striper action on Percy Priest. And folks, we recommend that you give him a call and get out on the water with Captain Joe James, because the action is awesome.
He's on it.
Oh, good. You know, we'll put him down about 4 foot and get started. Man, that looks like it. Well, that's
going in that motor, Jim. I'm trying my best.
You're going to have to bury it before I have it. Let me get it. Can we turn the motor up?
Joe's put us on them, ain't
he? Yes, sir. We ran in amongst them.
Dragon. Oh, that was at your
event. That one burnt my hand up.
Boy, that did.
How's it feel, Jim?
Good. Feel good. Oh, he's going to go there. There he goes down. He's going.
About
24. I'm going to hang on right now.
Pretty good fish?
Yeah, have a good fish, I think. He thinks he's bad anyway. Yeah.
There you go, big dog.
Now, supper's in about an hour and a half, okay?
How is it out here? We made fry right here.
What a fish, look!
Woo! I'm here catching the big ones, man. That's
my fishing.
That's it.
That's it.
Fish. What a fish. What a fish.
See, there ain't a lot of people that lift these like this. That's
man.
A fatty.
Look at that,
that's
Joe.
That's a good solid fish right there.
Sure is.
That's got to be pushing that 9 pound range.
Yeah, that's nine.
All right.
Jim?
2 for 2.
2 for 2.
Good job.
2 fish, 20 pounds worth of fish, man.
Somebody else is standing there.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's got to be the shirt.
Yeah.
That is awesome. Congratulations.
Well, folks, I'd like to think that that Fish and Affliction t-shirt that Jim's got on is helping him catch these big old fish. But the fact of the matter is, Captain Joe James has got us on a hot spot. And Jim Summers, well, he's got some fishing skills, of which I could use a lesson or two.
He got you into the buoy. Hey, just, hey, let him take line.
Yeah, just take him, let him take.
You got your drag loosened up?
Because he's going to get you around that line, then he'll come this way. Just let him take
you.
Fish. Cut it off. I'm not doing much with that marker.
Here. All right, thank you.
Sorry, I don't know where this one's at. Right, I think
hey, found him. There you go. There you go. Yours is down too.
Well, folks, after setting the hook on a good fish, it swam underneath the motor and cut the line. But all the while, Joe had one on, and we had a third one get on, and the action was just absolutely nonstop.
Rockfish.
I'm getting ready to have to duck your line. Now I'm gonna move around. Dan.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Woo! Get him, Joe.
What is going on here?
I'm not sure.
Here, let me have it.
Yeah, I got him. I got him.
Hey, it's around the tip.
I can't help it, big dog.
It'll break your rod.
Well.
Here, let me hold this for you.
Here you go. Stick it in the rod holder. Wow, what a fish. What a fish. Here you go. Woo! All right, big dog.
Here you go, take this one.
Go ahead, you got it.
Well, folks, the action is unbelievable, and it's mass pandemonium there on Percy Priest with Captain Joe James, the ultimate sportsman, Jim Summers, the big dog, and myself as we're chasing those big old hybrid and rockfish. And when we return, we're going to see what we just got into. But right now, it's time to head on upstairs to the kitchen to see what Miss Vicki Porter's cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and today we're going to dress up the roll-up. I know you're going to love this variation of my recipe for ham and fruit roll-ups. And now for the ingredients. You will need flour tortillas, cream cheese, mustard, ham, cheddar cheese, and apples. First, spread a thin layer of cream cheese on your tortilla. Now put about a teaspoon of mustard in the center. Now add a couple pieces of ham. Next, add your apples, add your cheddar cheese, and then roll this up. Once you roll them up, get ready to eat them up. Be sure and keep these refrigerated till time to serve. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the Skillet.
Kevin, what are you doing here?
Oh, I'm just filling in for Billy.
I need 660 shad crankbaits in the Series 5 model.
We're out.
You're not out. You got all kinds of them right there.
We're out.
Kevin, I need six.
Have a lollipop.
I do not want a lollipop.
Have a lollipop.
Do you have it in sexy shad color?
Hey everyone, if you're watching Fishin' Affliction, and I know that you are, that means you like information. And I want to tell you where you can get more information. First of all, Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency has a series of Facebooks. You go in, you can find the Facebook on the main website, tnwildlife.org, but then you can find regional Facebooks if you're from West to East Tennessee, Middle Tennessee, or over on the Cumberland Plateau. And hey, if you're outside the state, we do a lot of cool stuff on our Facebook. Dan has a Facebook. I have a Facebook. Facebook with us. See you next week on Fishin' Affliction.
Well, folks, today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight is more about your reel maintenance, and it's all about reel magic. That's right.
You know, I'd be squirting my reel down right now with some reel magic, but I forgot mine, and that's what's reminding me to tell you to bring it in the boat when you go. Squirt down your reels every time you use them, and it helps to preserve that line and give it longer life. Reel Magic by Blakemore is the thing to do for all your fishing reels and all your fishing line. And now back to Fishing Affliction. Welcome back to Fishing Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Aris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay in Charge Battery Charging Systems, Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts, Lowrance Electronics by BBGMarine.com, and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Wow, what a fish. What a fish. Here you go. Woo! All right, dog.
Here you go. Here you go, take this one.
Go ahead. You got it, you got it.
You know what? How do I end up with a rod with a fish on it?
Oh,
I was
my
on the front,
gosh.
The
Look
back.
At rockfish.
Now this is another hybrid.
Is it a hybrid? My gosh, look at that thing.
Monster hybrid.
My goodness.
What a giant, man.
Is that a monster or what, Joe? Sure, sure. Beautiful fish. Big dog?
You know what? I just figured out.
All right, what do you need me to do for you?
This one is bigger than you think because he has just now figured out he's hooked.
Well.
Woo!
I'm going to give you that. Come on, big dog. Using the whole boat. Well,
I'm going back to this.
I left a marker too.
Yeah. Wait till you see this, and he'll slime you down.
Okay, I'm missing rock.
Where you at now? This is a 5-minute clip. Joe, the action, it's quick and furious, isn't it?
Fantastic.
Isn't that awesome?
Beats a sharp stick in the hand.
Hey, I tell you what. Where you at, big dog? Wow, what another big hybrid. Wow. Man. Whoa. That is a huge hybrid.
Do you hear that? That is called drag.
Real music.
Real music. I like that, Joe. That's awesome. That's what we're gonna call the show. Real music on Percy Priest. I'm coming right by your side.
I'm gonna get this one on. Hey, come, man. I mean, I'm trying to get him up here, but I don't want to pull the hook out of him.
Just find him, big dog.
Back when me and Captain A have, we're at the big white one.
That's a 10-pound test, too.
10 pounds.
Yeah, that's 10-pound test. You got a 10-pound fish on a 10-pound test.
And he just cut it in.
Oh, he just barely hooked.
You want the net or you okay?
I'm not scared to pull too hard on you.
You want the net?
Nah, don't mouth again.
That's like landing a swordfish.
Hey, I'm fine with that.
Well, maybe.
Here, give him some slack. Throw him some slack, man. It'll be okay.
Slack. It'll be all right.
Pull that mark on here.
There you go, Jim. It's the hardest I ever worked for you having to catch a fish.
Tell you what.
Hey, if I was over the marker, I'd get the marker.
He's out of the marker.
Ooh.
Way to work him, Jim.
Way to go, Jim.
Jim.
You gotta hold him out.
You know that was on. Don't let him swim back in.
5 minutes. Control that fish, Jim. I'm trying to control him, and he got a mind of his own. Fish. Female. He got a mind of his own.
Oh, he went right back in it.
It's your fish under control, Jim.
He's back in it. Wow.
Woo!
Do that technique there. Jim, you just better get him yourself, my friend. Woo! What a dandy.
All right, thank you, Lord.
Woo! Jim, good how much job. Fun is that?
Now, I want to tell you one thing about this fish here.
All
right. I really don't think you caught it. You know why?
What, you tell?
No, because the hook ain't in his mouth. The hook was out of his mouth.
Where am I near?
Woo! Man, what a big fish.
That's a good one.
That's a big fish, right?
That's a rockfish right there.
No, that's a hybrid.
Is it a hybrid? I didn't see the...
Oh, that's a big...
Man, is that a
look
big
look at that big old hybrid right there, buddy.
Turn to give that Jim in there in the back so he can take a pick with it.
Take a picture, big dog.
Wow. Big dog, stay there with him, would you? I'll take a picture of both of you.
Yeah, get in here, man.
All right, you guys hold on. 1, 2, stay right there.
Well, folks, look at the smile on the ultimate sportsman, Jim Summers, and the big dog. I'll tell you what, those smiles say it all. And if you want some smiles just like that, then you need to call Captain Joe James. He's got an outstanding guide service, and he can sure put you on some fish. Whether it's hybrid and striper on Percy Priest or fishing for trophy stripers on the Cumberland River system, you need to call Captain Joe James. And Joe is also a member of the Percy Priest Hybrid and Striper Club, and here is the website information for this great fishing club. If you have any interest in catching hybrid and striper and doing it at a competitive level, or just want to see how it's done, go and check out this website because it's a great resource. And folks, thanks to all the fans of Fishin' Affliction for making this a certified fan favorite and for all the requests we've had to re-air and re-edit and reproduce this show for you. And folks, next week, well, we're going to be doing something that's really special because we're going to be doing some fun fishing with a whole bunch of friends of Fishin' Affliction TV. And we're going to be spending some time with an incredible young girl and her brother that I know that you're going to enjoy meeting. So tune in to Fishin' Affliction TV next week and you'll see. What are we going to do? We're going to try to catch a fish?
Yes.
Do you believe that he knows where the fish are at?
Very much so.
Big dog, you ready to catch him today?
I'm always ready to catch him.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is
Jesse Ergle.
And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
Ooh! Boy, look at this way.
27.09.